Right now, more than ever, your students need you. But how can you make those connections? Let's take a look. If we were all in school right now, it'd be business as normal. We'd be teaching academic content, but at the same time, we'd be building those emotional supports. We'd be checking in with our kids, and we'd be making those connections. But since that rug has been pulled out from underneath us, lots of teachers are struggling with making those connections with their kids. Now, I'm going to get into the how and the what you can do in order to make that successful, but first I want to take a second and talk about the why. Let's make a brief list of things that totally suck right now. Learning how to utilize an online calendar, and most likely more than one. How are we going to deliver academic content that's actually meaningful? Are my students getting the content that I'm even pushing out? All these new tech tools that I have to learn and integrate within my virtual classroom. And the list goes on and on. I know it feels like we're stuck in this never-ending Groundhog Day movie, but we still have to understand that kids are in the same situation as us. If anything, please don't forget that you are the anchor for your kids right now. If we're going to prioritize anything, we need to make sure that the number one thing is student connections. So first I want to take a dive into what. What is it that we can do to help make these connections with our kids? Afterwards, I'm going to get into the how, but first let's take a look at some ways that we can make some strong connections and provide a sense of normalcy for our students. The first thing we can do is just do a check-in or a post daily. It doesn't have to reinvent the wheel. It could be a 10-second selfie that you shoot and upload. It could be a simple blog post that you put to your Google Classroom. There are many ways to do it, but we want to make sure at least once a day you're posting something that the kids can connect to. Share with them what's going on in your world right now. Show some pictures. Talk about your experiences. Make it normal. Help them understand that they're not alone in this situation right now. Share your struggles with them. Let them see where you're coming from. It also helps just to circle that back around and ask them, does this happen to you too, or are you feeling the same way? Asking those questions and getting feedback from them is essential to the communication loop. It makes them feel involved. So make sure you post something every day. A second thing you can do is to start building some topic starters. Things that you can post that kids can discuss and talk about. Build off of their interests. Let them ask questions. If you see things that they're talking about, play off of that. Extend it. Let them build off of each other. You're going to be monitoring the situation and making sure the posts that people put are appropriate, but this is a great way to keep kids talking and to keep them engaged with what's going on. Again, we're not sacrificing the academic content. We're just placing a separate emphasis on things to do on the side for when they're finished with their work or when they're not even wanting to think about school. Now, building off of this, a third thing that you could do is create a space for students to just be silly. Let them post pictures of their pets. Let them have conversations about cartoons they're watching. Let them post a thread about what they're doing every day, things that may be trivial to you. Let them talk with each other in a dedicated space that's monitored by you, but by providing them that outlet, it gives them yet another way to feel normal and to connect with you and to connect with their classmates, something that they're vitally missing each day. A fourth great thing you can do is to revisit and reconnect with the school year. Things that have already happened, make those connections back to that. Ask them about their favorites. What was your favorite class? Do you remember when X? Do you remember when Y? Have them tell stories about funny things that happen, things on the playground, things in the cafeteria. Let them know and remind them that these things happened and that you're still part of that group. But perhaps most importantly, and the fifth thing that I want you to at least try to do on a daily basis is to let them know that you still care. You love them, you care for them, and you want the best for them. Things will get back to normal eventually, but for now, you just want to let them know that, hey, I'm here for you. We can still have school in a different type of way, but we're still a classroom, we're still together, even if it is virtually. Making that heart-to-heart connection is the most important thing, and if you take anything away from this video, let it be that. Okay, now let's get into some how. How can you do these things? What are some tools that you can use to make this available to you and make it easy? One cool website I like to use is called Symbaloo. It's an online site that you can gather links to other websites. You can curate it yourself, but this way you can have students send you links to websites that they like to go to. Now, of course, again, you're going to have to moderate, but if they have goofy, silly sites that they want to share with each other and get a collection of, using Symbaloo is a great way to put that together in a way that they can access it all in one place in one go. One of my favorite things to use is Flipgrid. If you haven't heard of it, I highly recommend you check it out. It's basically a website slash app that lets you record a question or a topic starter, you post it in a video format, and then it has a link to a code where kids can record their answers. As they do, they submit them to your board, and you get to start seeing all the video responses that students post. It's in a collection called a grid. This way, you can ask a question such as, hey, what did you do for this Easter? Students can respond, and as they build it out, they can go back and revisit that grid anytime to see what other kids had to say. It's a fantastic way to build camaraderie with your class and to see each other's faces. A third way you could do this is through using all of the Google tools that you have available to you. The first and probably most important thing you're gonna want is a Google Classroom. You need to get that set up because that way you can have a stream where people can have conversations and threads. This is where you get your topic starters going and your conversations that you can monitor all in one place. But it's also a place where you can assign classwork, you can post links, you can have everything in a one-stop shop. Once you do that, you can create some fun things for students to do using Google Slides. You can go in and have them post some of their favorite things. They can insert pictures, they can insert videos, they can insert anything that they want to type. Again, you're watching it and keeping an eye on it, but you can make some silly assignments that they can add slides to, and you can create one big presentation that they can share with each other. If you want to take it a little bit further, and some people already use this, you can have a Google site. It's free. All you need is your Google login. And using this, you can have many different pages for students to post things. They can build their own portfolios. They can document their journey through this whole crazy time. And you can have this where each student has their own page on your site. As time goes by and kids build up their assignments and projects that they finish, they can insert them onto the pages that you've built for them on a Google site. It takes a little bit of work on your end on the front part of it, but the rewards are amazing. If you decide that Google Classroom isn't your thing, you can still use a website called Edmodo. It's basically a Facebook feed for students. If you find yourself more familiar with that Facebook aspect of things, you can use this to connect with your kids. It's free, it's easy to use, and it has the same restrictions and safeguards that Google does. So if you want, take a look at that. Lastly, don't forget about your virtual meetings. Now I know that there's been a lot going on with Zoom and with Google Meet, and there's been a lot of debate with that. But whatever system you're using, make an online connection with your kids and host some virtual meetings. I know some of us are required to do this anyways on a weekly basis when we're talking about academic content, but I know there's also a lot of us out there who aren't allowed to do this. So right now there's a giant divide going on across the nation. But if this is something you can do, go ahead and set up a meeting once in a while for kids to just get together and be silly. I've got two great resources for you that I want you to check out. One here is going to show you all about the differences between Meet and Zoom, and this one right here is going to show you how to safeguard your Zoom meetings if that's what you choose to do. Regardless of what you choose, remember that connections with your kid is key. If you enjoyed the content that you've seen today, please consider subscribing, liking our videos, and sharing this with a friend. You guys are the lifeblood of our channel, and we couldn't do this without you. Also, don't forget that you can find us all over the place. We're on Teachers Pay Teachers, Twitter, Facebook, Pinterest, MrCooksCorner.com. Check us out when you get a chance, and also, if there's specific things that you'd like to see covered, let me know what you'd like to see, and I'm happy to post content to help you, the teacher. See you next time at Mr. Cook's Corner. Bye.